Okay, Chestnut Ridge Middle School, good afternoon. Today we are here with the boys soccer team and, with very select players from the boys soccer team. When I point to those players, they will raise their hand and say their first name and their last name loud and clear. And the newsletter club interviewees are? Guys, let's ask away.
Okay, so congratulations for being here. Each of you is here because Coach Nielsen spoke highly of you as team leaders. As a team leader, what are your responsibilities?
As a team leader, you will make sure that the team is all settled and not getting in arguments.
As a team leader, what Paul would just say, we have to do what the coach says most of the time, so.
Okay.
All I just said, we had to help others, you know, it's because we had to bring up the water, all the equipment, and we were the ones who would tell the other kids to do it.
So how many kids are on the soccer team roughly all together?
About 30.
How many?
30.
Well, so out of 30 kids on the soccer team, Coach Nelson gave me three names. What makes you guys so special? Like, why would Coach Nelson trust you with the responsibility of taking the water? You guys must have done something. You must have shown him on some level that you guys are responsible. Can you, any of you, elaborate on that a little bit?
We're 8 meters and more experienced and responsible.
Okay, that's great. Wonderful. What's the next question, guys?
What position do you play, and also what kind of responsibilities do you have playing?
I play outside mid, and what I have to do is I'll go back for defense, or I'll have to get the ball, run up a little, cross it in, or pass it to the middle.
I play striker, and most of the time I had to score goals, I guess.
I play midfielder, and I had to keep the middle steady and pass the ball up.
How long have you been playing soccer?
I've been playing since I was probably 3 or 4. My sister used to teach me how to play.
I used to play since 7 years old.
I used to play when I was 8 or 9.
How does it feel when you win? Also, how does it feel when you lose?
Well, when we win, we're just we just won. Some teams, we destroyed them. And then other teams, it was a close match. But then there's, those games where, you just lost, and what we would do is, we would get mad, as usual, but we would elaborate on what we did wrong and then do it, not do it the next game.
Normally when we won, we'd say good game, and then when we lost, we'd see, what we can do better.
When we won, we took it as, an achievement of, how good we did together with the chemistry. And when we lost, we focus on what we can do better.
Is it challenging to make the balance of trying to keep schoolwork and soccer?
This year it wasn't much. I would just get home and mom over. It wasn't really much.
No.
Can I stop you guys 1 second? Would you mind telling me I'm curious for myself, what league did you guys play, or did you or do you play for?
The Westchester League.
Westchester? And yours?
Westchester League.
Okay, thank you.
When is it challenging to work out an issue that the team is having? How do you guys negotiate?
We really just talked about it, We didn't really, keep it in. We wouldn't, we just get it out there so we don't have to do it again.
As a player, what areas in soccer can you improve on? And also, what areas have you shown improvement on this year?
I can improve on communication and to actually pass the ball to a player. And I've improved on my speed.
Communication. education, and I've been like, yeah, that's it. Communication.
All right, we're going communication and speed, I guess.
What are some things that everyone as a team can improve on? Also, what are some things the team has improved on this year?
Well, I mean, most of the kids from last year are here, so I guess the thing that we really improved on, well, there wasn't much that we improved on, but I guess everybody, like I said, we could improve on communicating and passing and shooting. Yeah.
So the
entire thing? No, not really. Just the one. We were young, like, we got better on our communication towards the end of the season while we were practicing after school. We got better with our team chemistry because, like, our first few games, we didn't really know each other. We didn't, like, know where to pass the ball. But, like, towards the end of the season, we knew, like where they would run and all that stuff.
Do you see yourselves playing soccer when you get to high school?
Sure.
Yes. Does anyone see themselves as a potential scholarship candidate? If so, how do you plan on making it happen? Jeffrey.
Yes. Because. Well,
yes.
Yes. And like, for me, like, I guess he's gonna be good at it, and so like, I just have to work on.
I don't really see myself playing for like, you know, like a whole team and stuff. I just do it as for fun.
No, because my grades could be better.
Thanks for meeting with us today. Is there anything else you would like to share with us?
No.
Guys, thank you so much, and I think we can call that a wrap.